Hello, my name is Kevin Rissi, and today I'm going to be going through assembly oil change procedures on the Jupiter 5 coil spring shock. This is the shock absorber that we're going to be first doing an oil change procedure on. Note that the spring has been removed from the shock. The shock still has bushings in it, however it has been cleaned. It is very important that the shock is clean from dirt and debris before you disassemble the shock. That way your environment of oil is very clean. So you remove the bushings from the shock, set them aside. And now we have a shock absorber ready to disassemble. One of the tools very important for servicing is to have a vise with aluminum jaws in it. That way you are not damaging or marring the finishes when you hold on to the shock. Clamp the shock and the vise on the body cap. You'll now be able to work on the shock. Again, the shock is in the vise, and the reservoir of the shock absorber is pressurized with nitrogen. This is very important for the performance of the shock to be pressurized so you don't have any cavitation. Remove the Schrader valve cap and then pressurize the shock by pressing the valve port, releasing the nitrogen pressure. Now you can remove the shaft assembly from the body assembly. It's a standard clockwise thread. Once it is loosened, then you can spin the whole complete shaft assembly out of the shock. Threads come out, this assembly comes out, and there's some oil that will be. The order of the parts here are the piston nut is first, and then a stack of washers. And it's important you keep all these parts in order. The top stack is the rebound stack, and it helps to put them onto the piston nut. This is the vise. The shock is now full of oil, and this oil is going to be poured out and removed. Shock oil. And at this point, you just want to get the majority of the oil out of the shock. Now you can set this aside. You take the shaft assembly of the shock, put this in the vise. Using a 12 millimeter socket, we remove the piston nut that holds the piston assembly. Next item is the piston itself, and it's important that it is put on correctly. There's one side that is compression and one side that is for the rebound. Next are the compression valves. Then there is the top out plate. Now at this point, you can remove the bearing seal housing from the shaft assembly. And now you have the shaft assembly by itself. Seals that are in the bearing, there's the primary wiper seal and the primary seal. And there's an outside O-ring. When the shock is disassembled, you can choose to replace the seals, or you can leave the seals if they're fine and just do a revalving and oil change on the shock. As we prepare to reassemble the shock, you want to clean the threads of the shaft so that it is free of oil. We're using an acetone and a spray bottle here, and that cleans and will evaporate off so that the Loctite that is used during the assembly will set up and cure correctly. The bolt tool is used to drop right on there, and that will allow the bearing to slide over the threads without cutting or scarring any of the internal seals. Okay, we have the bullet tool on top of the shaft, and we have a bearing with new seals in it. So we want to take some grease And it's important that you use nice high quality grease to lubricate the seals. A little grease inside the bearing. Putting it on the seals nicely. And a little coating on the shaft. And it's better to use more grease here than not enough, because you can clean it off really easily. Slide the bearing over and you can see it moves nice and smoothly. Remove the bullet tool. Next part that goes on is the top out plate. Plate sets on there. And then you have your compression stack of washers. For this one here, we have four valves of different thickness and diameters. Set the valves on top of the top out plate. Next is the piston itself. The compression side is flat, and it's a smooth surface. There are three large slots for the compression oil to flow through. The other side is the rebound side with three holes, and it is dished. The reason for the dish is to preload the valves on the rebound side. The compression side, the side with the three slots, goes down first. The piston nut, you want to clean the threads. Use some acetone to spray and clean the threads. Let that blow dry off. And use a few drops of red Loctite on the thread itself. Now when you thread it onto the piston shaft, the center of the valve needs to go onto the shoulder. It's a 12 millimeter X nut. Slowly tighten it. It's approximately 5 foot-pounds. 20 inch pounds. So you tighten it. Approximately 20 inch pounds of torque, and then that will cure up and the piston nut will be set on the shaft. Okay, you have the piston nut with the rebound valves on it. Use a little bit of acetone to clean the threads on the piston nut so they're free of oil and any debris. Drop the red Loctite, put that on the internal threads, and then slowly thread the piston nut onto the shaft, making sure that the valves sit correctly on the shoulder of the piston nut. Once you've snugged it, now you want to use the 12 millimeter wrench, and you'll tighten this down to about 10 inch pounds. 10 to 20 inch pounds, but mostly it is the red Loctite that cures and sets the nut. On the piston nut, the six flats need to align with the three holes, so that the hole is, three holes have a flat in front of them. And to do that, you align it and then rotate the piston as you tighten the piston nut, that it remains in the same position. Set this aside again. Okay, now we take the body of the shock, once again place it into the vise, so it's separated out. The reservoir at this point has no pressure. You want to turn the compression adjuster all the way counterclockwise, so it's the least compression setting. And now we're going to pressurize the reservoir. About 50 psi of nitrogen. What that will do is it will move the separator piston all the way down, so you'll have the maximum volume of nitrogen in the reservoir. And then we'll pour oil into the shock body. We'll use the AccuFill, which first goes on here. Nitrogen in a pressurized tank. This little fitting here allows us to compress the valve core, set the pressure, and remove the tool without losing pressure. The valve core closes first. So now this is set with nitrogen pressure. Standard oil is 5-weighted shock oil. slowly pour the oil into the shock body. And you want to go until you're just below the top, about an eighth inch to a quarter inch below the top of the bottom. Now we take the shaft assembly and make sure the rebound adjuster is turned out, so you have the minimum rebound adjustment setting. The shaft assembly itself is now ready to install. Slowly work it in, and you'll see the oil start to be displaced and flow out of the shock body. The main thing you're trying to do here is to keep any air from getting into the shock. So that's why you overfill the shock and then allow it to bleed out. So a bleed slot, so as this is turning, the oil bleeds out. Slowly spin this in. You want to be sure you don't hit the shaft of the shock with your wrench, because you could potentially scratch your bearing. So continue to thread it. Oil is bleeding out until the O-ring seals. Bring it start to seal, and it's just another half turn or so. Okay. It's now tight. The shaft itself can rotate relative to the body of the shaft. Press it. See that it returns. Turn the adjuster in. And that slows the rate of return to the point where you can actually stop the travel. Now with the spring on the shock, it will return at a much faster rate. But right now it is returning by the pressure of nitrogen. Okay. At this point you should clean the shock. And once again, you can use something like acetone, simple green, any type of cleaner to remove the oil. So after cleaning the shock, I'm now ready to put the spring back on. And a lot of times you'll turn the knob, the rebound knob on, so there's plenty of clearance. Slide the spring over. And you want to turn the preload ring down. Just like you can install the spring here, but slide that up. And now the spring is installed on the shock. At this point, you can put the valve cap onto the reservoir and reinstall the bushings.